tall seated position, eyes closed down, spine tall, might be kneeling or cross-legged, place that you can bring yourself into stillness. Take a moment to simply observe the breath. Breath traveling in through the tip of the nose, out through the tip of the nose. Observe the breath as it lands in your body. The inhalation, an invitation into the present moment. The exhalation, grounding, centering you in to the here and now. Draw the breath a little bit longer, slower and deeper, with each inhale filling abdomen, ribs, chest full of breath. Exhale from the chest, the ribs, and then the abdomen will draw back in, empty of breath. Letting go of any expectations you may have for your body or for your practice. Let go of the outcomes, what you think should happen. Simply be okay with whatever comes up for you. Two more deep, expansive breaths here. And on the next inhalation, reach the arms wide to the sides. Lift out of the side waist, bring the arms in line with the ears. Keep stretching up. Exhale, rounding the buttock bones down. Feel the shoulders drop down away from the ears. Inhale, fingertips stretch taller. Maybe the eyes gaze slightly up. And as you exhale, turn the palms out to the sides and press the hands down and away, dropping the shoulders. The weight of the world drops off of the shoulders. One more time, inhale, arms reach. Eyes can gaze up. Exhale, release. You'll bring yourself with crossed legs so the feet are a little in front of you. Hold on to the shins and the ankles. We'll begin by rocking forward onto the pelvis, guiding the sternum, the breastbone forward, and on the exhale breath, rounding in the upper back, rocking backwards to the back of the pelvis. The inhale brings us forward. The exhale backwards. Keep the head and the neck rather still and continue to rock forward and back. Feel the space across the front body on each inhale. The space down the back body on each exhale. You'll gradually increase the speed as your breath allows, asking breath to come a little bit faster than it was before. We'll invite the body to move a little bit faster. A little bit of dynamic movement through the hips, through the spine, through the shoulders, rocking forward, backwards, forward, backwards. Might even get up to quite a quick pace. Inhale, exhale, only if the breath can take you there. No need to move the body any faster than the breath can come. Ten more seconds. A nice, calm, deep breath through the back of the throat. On the inhale, arch the spine, lift the chest, reach the arms. See if you can hold the breath inside. If you need to release breath, keep the arms lifted. Take another deep breath in, full of breath. Pull the pelvic floor up. Pull the belly in. Relax the shoulders, reach up. And as you exhale, soften the belly. Release the arms down. Roll the shoulders up back. Hands directly beneath shoulders, knees directly beneath the hips. Middle fingers are parallel, spread the fingers wide apart. Start off nice and slow with cat and cow by curling the toes. On the inhalation, arching the spine, lifting the chin. On the exhalation, pointing the toes, rounding the spine, scooping up the belly. On the inhale, we stretch the bottoms of the feet out. Open the chest and the heart center. And on the exhale, breath, press down deeply into the tops of the feet, the shins, the ankles, and round up the back body. Now your choice to stay here. Nice, long, slow, calm, deep breaths. Or again, gradually increase the speed of the breath. As you increase speed of breath, you'll increase speed of movement. Once again, you can move up to a rather rapid pace. This is really quite useful, bringing energy into the spine, helping to shift stagnant energy, as well as waking up the whole spine. We're waking up the adrenal glands, keeping the breath flowing dynamically through the body. If you need to slow back, feel free. Just another 10 seconds, a little bit faster if you can. Inhale, drop the chest, open the heart, hold the breath inside, face is soft. Hold it in, pelvic floor is up. And then exhale, round the spine, scoop up the belly, push all the breath out. See if you can hold here, empty of breath. Then sinking the hips back towards the heels. Knees can come apart. The backs of the hands are going to rest down to the palms are facing up in offering. Gently set the forehead down to the mat if you can reach. Taking a few breaths here. Stay down in child's pose. Allowing the front of the forehead to sink down, the bridge of the nose to drop down. Here we take a moment to sort of rest down the front of the brain, where all the fluctuations of the mind, the overthinking, the logic brain, lives. We're going to set that down here on the mat. It'll be there when you get back. Give yourself a moment to release those unnecessary thoughts. And in offering the palms facing the ceiling, we offer up this practice to whatever may come, whatever may shift, and whatever may be. Slowly coming back up to the knees. On the inhale, rise all the way up. Feel the whole front body open, chin lifts. On the exhale, breath around the spine. Scoop the belly, sink the hips to the heels. The inhale, breath brushes up over the front body. The exhale, breath pours down the back body. Inhaling up. Exhaling. Strong breath. Start to bring that breath more through the back of the throat if you can, still traveling in and out through the nose. Inhale, elevating your energy, lifting you. Exhale, release. Inhale. And exhale. And just one more inhale. And exhale. I'm going to take quite a strong breath exercise. Please feel free to slow back or gradually increase the speed as fast or as slow as it feels right for you. The inhalation will extend the arms wide apart, fingers spread wide. The exhalation will make a little fist and draw the upper arms and elbows into the side ribs. It's quite a strong compression here, working through the lymphatic system. Inhale and exhale strongly. Inhale, exhale. Feels okay, we're going to gradually increase the speed. Continue. Keep the eyes softly closed. Try to turn your inner gaze up to the third eye center, to the space between your eyebrows in the middle of the forehead. A little bit stronger here. If you can, strong breath in and out through the nose, through the back of the throat. Shoulders up, back, and down a few times as you bring breath to a nice, long, slow, calm, deep flow. I'm going to come forward to lying on the belly. Rest the hands a bit wider than the mat so you're high on the fingertips. Relax the bottom. Relax the lower back. Three times only here. The inhale will lift just the chest. The exhale lowers it back down. Try to keep your lower back soft. The inhale, just the sternum softly lifts. Exhale. Relax the shoulders. Neck stays long. Inhale up. Exhale down. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders. The elbows pull into the ribs. Hands feel like they're pulling backwards. We're not pushing down, but rather pulling hands and elbows back. The inhale peels the spine forward and up. The exhale lowers us back down. Don't worry about how high up you're getting. Just feel as much into the stretch across the front body as you can. Little compression in the lower, the middle back. Just sending some heat and energy back there. Make sure hands and elbows are pulling back towards the hips. Face, face up. Two more here. Relax the shoulders. Maybe coming up a little bit higher if it feels good. Nothing forced. One more. This time, pressing up into the knee. Draw the body away from the floor. And then lifting the knees up. The feet will come to about hips distance apart, your first downward facing dog. Might need to bend into one knee, extending the other. So if you're bending the right knee, the hips shift slightly right side, the left leg stays straight, heel down. Just try a couple more times. Feeling nice and loose in the hips. If the arms or shoulders feel a bit tighter, start to press the hands a little bit more forward. Bring the feet to still, and as you press forward through the hands, lift the buttock bones higher. Relax the shoulders, relax the head and the neck. Take a few more deep breaths here. More conscious of the extension in your spine. So don't worry about the legs. If the heels are up and the knees are softly bent, that's okay. Keep pushing hands forward. Relax the shoulders down. Point the buttock bones up. And over time, the legs will get a little bit straighter. Two more full breaths here. Not an easy task to hold downward facing dog this long. Stay here. One more full breath. And you'll begin to walk the hands backwards towards the feet. Walking your hands back to the feet, feet hips distance apart. Soft bend in the knee and let the upper body just hang forward. You can keep the hands on the floor for support or latch onto each elbow. Shifting the head and the neck from side to side gently. Here in this forward fold, do engage the lower belly. Pull the pelvic floor up, pull the belly in. Shift more body weight forward to the balls of the feet. And with the help of gravity, really allow your spine to decompress. Let it go. If you do have a hold of the elbows, just switch out the grip so the opposite hand's in front.
Check in that the weight hasn't shifted back into the heels, but rather forward towards the balls of the feet, and then it's the crown of the head that's facing the floor. One more full round of breath here. And then exhale, release the hands. Notice how much further you come. Inhale, slide the fingertips up the shins. The legs might get a bit straighter, the spine long. And then as you exhale, bend the knees, press the hands down. Inhale, extend the legs, extend the spine, look slightly forward. Exhale, fold. One more inhale, extending, holding here. On the exhale, hands to knees, bend the knees. Cat and cow standing, the inhale arches the spine, points the buttock bones back and up. The exhale rounds the spine, scoops the buttock bones down. Inhale to arch open across the collarbones, across the throat. Exhale. Inhale, arching. And exhale, to wrap. One more inhale. Exhale. Inhale, so come all the way up to standing. Reach the arms wide. Exhale, release the hands down by the sides. Bring your hands onto your hips, feet parallel. Maybe about shoulders distance apart here. We're going to make some huge circles with the hips. Driving the hips around, kind of smoothing out any of the jagged edges that are in the hips and the pelvis. Big, huge circles here with full deep breaths. And then switching the direction of those circles. Take some nice, really nice deep breaths. Now you're going to stay standing. Just drop down to my knees. You stay standing on the feet. Hands reach down by the thighs. Inhale, the arms reach out and up. The palms face the ceiling. Arms come to the ears. As you exhale, push the backs of hands together. Stretch the fingertips more away. Push the palms down. Spine is tall. Inhale, arms reaching up. Crown of the head is lifting up. Lengthening taller. Exhale, push all of the breath out of the body. So we're trying to match the movement with the breath. Inhale, extending, expanding, bringing in fresh breath. Then exhale, releasing and letting it all go. Just one more time like that. Inhale, the arms reach up. On the exhale breath, we stop with the hands in line with the shoulders. Flex at the wrist, press through the palms. Stay where you are. Try to tuck ribs in. Lift pubic bone up, buttock bones down. Head and neck look to the right side. See the right middle finger flexing, pulling back. Shoulders soften. Head and neck look across to the left side. Flex through the wrist, press through the palms, fingertips back. Head and neck back to the center. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Draw the knuckles down and roll the collarbones open. Still standing. Teeth together and chin looks slightly up. Relax the shoulders down. Slowly release the chin towards the throat. Shoulders pull down. Head and neck to center. Inhale the arms back up. Exhale again, dropping them halfway down. Flex at the wrist. Push through the palm. Then make a fist with your hands and draw your knuckles down. Go the back of the wrist, get that nice stretch. And let's take some big circles here. Wrist circles, but pulling the hands and the knuckles as far away from your body as you can. Good. I'm going to come back up to standing with you. Release your hands down by your sides. Feet about hips distance apart only. Take a deep breath and sit the hips back like you're in a chair. You can keep the arms straight in front, sink a little bit lower, or if the shoulders and neck allow, let the arms start to reach up. Maybe even the head and the neck will look up. Sink a little bit lower, send the body weight backwards so your knees come back behind your toes. Your bum goes low and the belly pulls in. Good.
Just two more breaths. Relax the shoulders. Slide the arms. One more. Slowly come back to standing. Roll the shoulders up, back, and down. And we'll take it all the way back down to the floor. Inhale the arms, reaching up. Exhale, forward fold, bend the knees. Hands come to the floor. Inhale, fully extend the spine, look forward. Exhale, press the palms down and take baby steps, really small steps to walk the feet backwards. Hips are high, shoulders stay over top of the wrists, lower to a push-up position. Set the knees down, roll the elbows inside. See if you can bring your chest to the floor. Thighs, hips, and belly will follow. Inhale, feel the chest open. Exhale, press back to to child's pose first. Hips to heels. Take a nice deep breath here. Rise all the way back up to those knees.
We finish with a strong, dynamic breathing exercise to set you up for the day ahead. Inhale, reach the arms straight up. Exhale, make a fist. Draw the elbows along the ribs. Pull them backwards. Squeeze your shoulder blades. Breath will get strong. Inhale and exhale. In and out through the nose. Inhale and exhale. Gets a little bit faster. If you can, close down the eyes. Send the eye gaze up to the space between the brows. Slowly let the arms fall down. You can stay kneeling or come back to a comfortable cross-leg position. Lengthen the spine up. Find that deep, deep nostril breathing once again, in and out through the nose, in and out through the back of the throat. Feel the belly rising with each inhale and falling back down with each exhale. Just going to do a couple of rounds of alternate nostril breathing. Feel free to do more rounds on your own as well. Place your right thumb on your right nostril. Exhale all of the breath out until you're empty. We inhale deeply and softly through the left nostril. Close the left nostril. And exhale through the right. Inhale through the right. Close and exhale through the left. Close down the eye. Inhale softly through the left. At the top, pause the breath and exhale through the right. At the bottom, observe the pause. Inhale through the right. Close and pause. Exhale through the left. Observe the pause at the bottom. Inhale through the left. Close and hold. Exhale through the right. Observe the pause at the bottom. Inhale, right side. Close and hold. And exhale through the left. Completely empty of breath, release the right hand. Thumb and index finger come to touch. Face soft. Spine. Fully extended. Heart two hands to press in front of the heart center. Rub the palms together slowly. Placing them over the eyes, breathe in deeply. And as you exhale, softly blink the eyes open and release the hands. And have a beautiful day.